Hi there, my name is Cody Cooper. I'm a sales engineer here at B9 Creations, and today I'm going to show you how to 3D scan our solitaire ring on our B9 Scan 350. Now let's delve into what we have here on the table. We've got the B9 Scan 350, which is a computer and a 3D scanner all in one, so no other computer is needed here. Then we have our 3D scanning spray. This is to prevent shiny surfaces from reflecting the light projection that the scanner uses. Next, we have a brush. This helps remove any excess of the dust that we have. And then a little bit of sticky tack in order to stick our samples to this working plate right here. And then we have our regular desktop setup. So with that, we'll get started on scanning this ring. I'm going to take the ring. I'm going to place it right in the middle of that sticky tack, and usually with jewelry, you're going to need about 2 scans in order to get a complete ring. So I want to start off by getting the top detail here. We're going to spray the shiny surfaces of the ring, which is just about everything on this one, so I'm going to get full coverage with this. Take a spray, and then I'm going to dust it like so, turning as you go. So now we have a bunch of this excess on the working plate. I'm going to wipe that off with the brush here. And there we go. All the excess is out. So now I'm going to open our scanner hood there and I'm going to carefully place the working plate inside of the scanner. As you can see, we're using our B9 Level 1 acquisition. There are multiple lists here, but we're going to go with this one. This is the distance from top of the part that we're scanning, and then we have a detail. We want max detail on this, and so because it's such a small part, we can get the max detail without running the system too slowly. Gonna click scan here. Now it's going to go through a series of scans projecting light at different angles and orientations of the ring. This process usually takes about 1 to 3 minutes. Now we've scanned our ring in 2 different orientations. The software makes it easy to merge into one by selecting similar data points on both of the scans. As you can see, it's snapped to a region that it's close to the original, but it is off slightly. Now with this tool, you do not need to be 100% dead on in order to get the scan. You can just be close, and then you hit register, and it will recognize similar polygons and fuse into a final mesh here. So we're going to hit merge. And there we go. And then we're going to hit apply and move on to the next step. So this is the final step of repairing any major flaws in the part itself. So as you can see, there's a fairly large hole in the scan right here. And we're going to use one of our tools to quickly close that up. There we go. And then we're going to use the final tool to closed reconstruct the entire mesh. This will close any of the excess holes and smooth out the surfaces in general. And our final result is this ring right here. So you can take your scan directly to 3D printing or to import into your CAD software. If you need any more information, please visit us on our website, and thank you for watching.